Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sanjeev Yadav, Assistant Professor in Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at Government Women Engineering College, Ajmer. Today, with a new topic, that is cable TV. We can also that CATV. Disclaimer, this PPT is used for the teaching purpose and most of the material has been taken from the internet, including picture. The author does not claim any copyright for this material and no legal action is authorized for the same. Cable TV. As we all have seen that before dish TV, we all are having the cable TV at our homes. There the cable is coming through the wires, coaxial cables. Basically, cable television is a system of delivering television signals with access to television program to consumers. In this system, the signals, that is the RF signals, are transmitted through coaxial cables. And as of now, they are transmitted through fiber optic cables in the subscriber premises. It needs to have a distribution network. History. The cable television system was originated in US in late 1940, and it was designed to improve the reception of commercial network broadcast in remote and hilly areas. During 1960, cable TV was introduced as many large metropolitan areas where local television reception is degraded by the reflection of signals from tall buildings. Now, this is the block diagram of cable TV. Here we can see that at the top there is an antenna is there. We have seen at the olden times, approximately 20 years ago, that they are very big dish TV antennas are there, which are at only with the cable providers. They are receiving the RF signals through those antennas, and then through the networking, means through the cables, they are transmitting those signals to the users. As we can see that here, the signal is transmitted through the coaxial cable. Then it is split into two parts. This way, it is going there, and through the taps, they are going to the homes, means to the subscribers. Similarly, this way, they are going to the subscribers. One more thing. Here, it is going through the coaxial, but here, the signal is going through the fiber cable, and then there is optical to electrical converter that is changing the optical signal into the electrical signal, and again that electrical signal is traveling through the coaxial cable, and this is hybrid fiber coaxial HFC segment that we will study in detail. Means this way the network is needed. This is the network which is needed, as well as that cable is needed, and in the middle some repeaters, means some amplifiers, are required, because as the signal is traveling, some of the losses will be there. They will degrade the quality of the signal, so their repeaters, or we can say the amplifiers, are required in the between, here like that, or after 2 homes or after 10 homes like that. It depends on the quality of the signals. Here, these are the components of the cable TV. Cable network, as I told you about the cable network, means how the network, the wire network, is started from the starting point to the end users, that are the subscribers. Nodes, as we can see that the here, these are the nodes, how this is being transmitted. Line amplifiers, as I told you about the amplifiers, we need the amplifiers in between so that the quality of signal cannot be degraded. Power supply. For running these amplifiers or in the between devices, they need some power. But the service provider cannot take the power from the subscriber. So in this regard, the cell or battery is needed to operate these devices. Cable network. It is shared cable system that uses a tree and branch topology in which the multiple households within a neighborhood share the same cable. As the cable is there, it is going there, and from that through the taps, it has been signal has been provided to the subscribers. Line amplifier inserted in the branch line to make the cable losses that connects the distribution system. Means when we are just cutting the cables, at that time the connection losses are there, or while traveling the signals, the cable loss is there. So the line amplifiers are needed, and they are having the typical gain from 20 dB to 40 dB. Trunk amplifier with equalizers are used at the regular intervals in the trunk system to overcome the losses in the cable, which increases towards the high end of the spectrum. These trunk line repeaters provide the gain about 20 dB, and they compensate the corresponding losses of a cable around about 600 meter. Means they are not at 10 ohm, 20 ohm, they are approximately about 600 meters, depending on the type of cable, and they are used to maintain the signal level 1 to 3 millivolt. The power supply, the battery is used for operating these trunk amplifiers, line amplifiers. As I told you about the modern hybrid fiber coaxial cable television system, here we can see that this is the complete distribution point, and from the distribution point we can see that the optical fibers that is going towards the 5 kilometers to 40 kilometers here, that has been distributed through the optical fibers. As we can say that there is less loss in the optical fibers, as well as the signal quality is very good, and the bandwidth is also very high, so the high quality signals can be transmitted through these optical fibers. And after the optical fiber, here we can say the optical signal is being changed into the electrical signal, and they are being transmitted through the coaxial cable, and then the trunk amplifier is used. And after that has been topology has been used, the tree topology means it has been, and in between there the line RF amplifiers are being used. Similarly here they are using, or we can using everywhere like that. At in the mid of the town there is the service providers are there, and they have the network to distribute the cable to each and every home throughout a large area. And it can be, if they are situated in a very long, then they are using the optical cables. If there is a very short span, they are using the coaxial cables. Now the multiplexers. What is the need of multiplexers in this cable TV? In cable distribution center, many channel signals are separated, modulated, and frequencies allotted to each channel. To distribute these channels to users, many channel signals must put into one signal cable. That's why the multiplexing is being used. Attenuator. They are used to equalize the signals, to mix the signal at different proportion, reduces distance by specific value, which is expressed in dB. Means again, whatever the power is being attenuated, so to equalize the signals, that unit are used. Now there are many service providers in India. In India there are more than 700 channels are being telecasted in main and regional languages in the nation. The main service providers throughout the country are the DigiCable Networks, Hathway Cable and Datacom, Innocent Media and Communication, that is InCable, Den Network. These are some of the service providers in India. Now what are the advantages of cable TV? The cost of the cable TV is low. It is providing good service. It is just providing through the local area. It is also provides the local channels, which we cannot see through the DTH or through the HDTV or the, like that. It offers good packages of channels. It provides many channels, as some standard channels as well as the local channels, so that they are the local distributors, so they are giving very good offers, so that the people can take their cable TV. Also provides signals wide band while bad weather conditions, but its strength may degrade. because the cable TV, there's a signal, they are coming from a distance. So at that time, the weather is not proper at your place. It may be proper at the where the antenna is being installed. So, but at the DTH that is, has been installed at your rooftop. So when the weather is not working, means weather is not clear, if the signals may not come to your television, but during the this cable TV, the signal is coming from the too far. So during the bad weather conditions, it may work. Now the disadvantages of cable TV. It is providing different operators are providing different cost. Here we cannot demand the video. Internet is not available, gaming is not available, and it is not providing the high quality signals because of the coaxial cable. The bandwidth is low as compared to HDTV or any other, as well as the single cable is being transferred to thousands or hundreds of homes or subscribers, so the quality may degrade. And while using the HD channels, quality we will not get. Thank you. For any query, you can just message me. We'll meet with a new video. Thank you.